shipwreck way out on the ocean, swimming blind, Lord, praying in a whole wind.
Hey everyone, it's Ash and Danny once again. We're going to check out one of our new spots. Not sure how well you can make it out on this camera, but there's all these sort of dead trees you might see down there. Got no idea what was here, but the landowner said the whole area was just littered with houses back in the day, so we'll see what we see. Yeah, we'll bring you in if we get any finds. Thanks for watching. So this is the first spot. You can see all these trees here. There's a bit of iron and some bricks over there, maybe. Definitely something there, so yeah, it's pretty good. We'll see what we get. There's a motorbike track right over there, which is a bit noisy, but I have to live with that, I suppose. Anyway, we'll bring you in soon. It's turning out to be quite hard going here. Danny reckons the house that was here probably exploded through the amount of sheet metal and stuff that's around. So the first real find I've dug's a small nondescript knob of some sort. Could be off a lamp or something, so... Anyway, we'll stick it out for a bit longer here. I can see a few other piles around where there's probably been houses, you know, chimney remains and stuff like that. So we'll see what we see. We're about to move spots because it's quite hard going here. Lots and lots of junk. It's possibly been detected before as well because there just doesn't seem to be many non-ferrous type targets. That said, I just dug ahead. Looks like a kangaroo, which is cool. It's quite shiny too, as though it was silver, but I think it's pewter, just looking at the corroded parts. Could be silver, you never know. It's pretty cool though. On we go. Hooked up another old find here. It's an old pocket knife. Well and truly disintegrated, but you can see the remains of it. Would have been quite a cool shape actually. Sort of a curved end on it. Brass little trims, blades well and truly gone. Didn't see any evidence of it, but yeah. We still haven't actually left this spot. We keep working our way to the fringes and then coming up with targets, so we'll get over to this other place eventually. But next one was a nice brass buckle, I guess. Really nice, very solid, probably off a bit of saddle tack or something like that. Very nice. Okay, so we've come for a bit of a drive up the hill here, and it's looking pretty housey. Nice old trees and some of these bushes, rocks and such, so might be completely wrong, but we'll soon see. Well, there's definitely things here. First dig for me is a pocket watch face, I reckon. You can see the porcelain on it. It's been folded in half and seemingly crushed intentionally, but yeah, that's a good start. Danny's over there with finding lead with holes in it. So yeah, with finds like that, we've got to stick here. So we've had pretty much a surface find here. It's some of this costume jewelry. I won't try and clean that side off, but I think it may not be broken. We think someone else has been detecting here and they've just discarded what they don't want, which is pretty painful. I found a heap of surface finds. How about you? Yeah. Danny's just found a buckle just laying on top, so...
I think it's a clock.
Ah, it's a clock frame, actually. Well, that's great. I'll find all the gears out of that pretty soon. Anyway, that's... Yeah, it's kind of cool. I like finding this stuff. Some of it's really nice. We'll keep on. This place has definitely been done, which is unfortunate, but Danny's come up with a few little things, a few buckles and buttons and stuff. A lot of glass around. Yet to find a whole bottle, which is a shame. But yeah, I've just come up with silver, finally. Just a little pendant of some sort. I can't see any hallmarks on it. There may be something. It's nice, it's got a little flower on it. It's intact as well, you could chuck that on a chain and use it. Very cool.
Nice. Well, that's a good sign. We're about to head up to another place. We're just sort of driving through the paddock, really, looking at trees, trying to pick all the old ones and stop, see how we go. This spot here is just like digging through glass and crockery. There's barely any dirt. You have a look in this hole, there's just glass and stuff everywhere. And dug out a lock. It's a nice one too, it's all brass. Clean up really well, that one. Warranted secure. Almost gouged it too, which was lucky. Handmade. In reality, they're flimsy as. If you wanted to break into a place, you could snap this thing in about 2 seconds, I reckon, but they gave a feeling of security. So that's nice. Normally the, there we go. It even opens up. Normally this arm's steel and it rusts off, but it's really good. Awesome. We'll stick here for a little bit. Still in this little dump area. Just dug this thing up. Another one of these bizarre things. It's got a patent number inside, which is always good. And name, JR London. Patent number 7321. Almost certainly find out what that's off and chuck some pictures in for you. Got a bit more silver here, I think. Found similar things to this before. This thin, I think it's silver. I don't see what else it would be, but it's a thin foil. This has a design on it. It looks like a couple of nail holes or pinholes. Don't know. It could be off a jewelry box or, you know, wrapped around a stick. Don't know. Who knows? Any thoughts on that? Let me know and I'll put the info in. Danny's come up with a lighter, like an old Zippo or something. Oh yeah. Jeez, it is old, isn't it?
Yep.
Weird. Could be a name on that somewhere.
Maybe.
Yeah, it's sort of electroplated or gilled or something like that. There you go. Just got a nice little flat button here. It's a brand I've never actually dug before. Four holes in it. RC Hagen, Sydney. Nice brass, it's in good nick too. Clean up really well. Ripper. We're doing it tough here. We've got the coffee on. Just come to another spot here. Danny's half asleep. you really can't see anything at the moment, but I saw a few bricks around, a few piles of rocks which look chimney-ish. You can see here actually, got these row of rocks here. It's a bit of a square, you can see. So it's definitely been something here. We just finished our feed and come up with a penny. Bad condition, this one. Pretend you though. And quite old, I think. Just hang on one sec. Oh, well, 1891. In fact, that may not be too bad, actually. Young head, Victoria. Yeah, pretty cool. Well, it's a coin anyway. That's awesome. So we've abandoned the other place for the moment. We weren't finding heaps. People had been there before detecting a lot of holes and stuff left on the surface, which is a bit disappointing, but we've come back to the spot we're at last weekend in the last video. Fines are still coming up. I've got 1240, I think, here, which is promising. May not be a coin, but hopefully something decent. Mystery object. think it's got some writing on it. Should be able to get some sort of info on it. I have no idea what that is right at the moment. Interesting. And he's onto a coin. Half penny. Edward, is it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Did you pick the year on it?
No.
Yeah, it's in bad nick, though.
Yeah, it's not very nice.
What, 1900 and something? Cool, Danny scored a second coin. 1912 penny. Yeah, that's going to be in good condition, isn't it?
Yeah, it looks pretty good.
Nice. There you go. It's a good spot, this one.
Yeah.
All right, we're going to call it a day. We got a few coins, I suppose, and a couple of nice relics. It's much quieter than last week, though. But, yeah, it was all good. You got some good stuff, didn't you?
Coins.
Yep.
Pieces.
Yeah. Anyway, we'll hopefully be out maybe tomorrow. Probably next weekend though. Clean up all those finds and do some stills as usual, and we'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.
There's no cure for them jungle blues.